welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry K. Now, I've just had Best Bitter from the Hackney Brewery. It was lovely.
Lovely!
Just soothing, relaxing, quintessentially English pint of beer. I'll say pint, 500 millilitres of beer. Right, now, we're going on to the next one now. We've got one slightly chilled. But I've let it warm to the right temperature and everything else. It's all good. Right, but it's made the label a bit wet. I think the labels need, not the design, the design's perfect, but the labels were a little bit soggy. A little bit kind of chip paper. That's not a complaint. That's just kind of me being ultra critical. And I think sometimes you've got to be a little bit ultra critical with beers, because as much as it hurts people, if the beer's no good, they need to know about it. With that said, the Best Bitter was glorious. So let's go on. We've got the Golden Ale. They've only got a few out at the moment, but they're kind of going in quick there. Getting a few out quick and fast. Got ingredients, water, malt, hops and yeast, all good. And it's all proper stuff, none of that kind of, you know, rubbish. Right, there is the crown. I ain't gonna put it up on bottle cap Jenga yet, because it's proper, well, go on, let's try it, go on. Whoa! Actually scored. Let's go for it, pour it out. Oh, I did get it slightly shook, I think. Let's see what we look like. Nice little head I've just poured on it. Lovely creamy fluffy head. Beautiful creamy fluffy head. Oh, that smells nice. That smells nice. Something big and fruity just punched me up the ooter. Kind of dissipating slightly. I'll shake it round again, get a bit more. Yeah, we're talking kind of lychees, kumquats, apricots. Again. Tiny bit of I don't believe that. Let's have another go. Tiny bit of gooseberries. And a nice little bit of peach and hot orange in there. Rather tangerine, I'd say. Biscuits. You've got a kind of hard biscuit, like one of these like rich tea sort of ones. It's not those big fat sort of butter sort of biscuits. It's not those so much. So you've got lots of kind of lovely fruity hops in there, and you've got a nice little gentle back note of malt. There's and a little bit of sweetness in there. A slightly sort of sweet malt as well. Right, let's dive in. Cheers. Ooh, that's weird. That's beautiful. Do you know what? You get I've just been to the GBBF, and sometimes I think the nation is losing its identity a little bit. There's nothing wrong with the great big kind of juicy Carmen Miranda hops and things, big fruit bowls and everything else. There's nothing wrong with them. They're very, very nice. Really lovely. But it seems that, all the beers that I, well, not all of them, but most of the beers I tasted at the GBBF was great big hop bombs full of stuff, you know, full of different fruits and that. And that's very nice. But, you know, you go to a restaurant or something like that, you can't just live on the fruit bowl. You can't just go for, you know, you don't order the desserts and that's it. you know. And I think kind of the nation's kind of getting too impressed with all your Amarillos and your Galaxies and your Citras, and it's kind of forgetting beers like this. And it takes a beer like this to just go, oi, do you remember this? Yeah, there may be something like a Cascade in there or something like that, you know, but it's just such a lovely beer, such a really nice beer. There's one thing these guys do really, really well, and it's making those quintessentially English, British beers in it that you kind of, that just are so well done, you know, so beautiful, but kind of becoming forgotten a little bit. Go in a pub and taste this, and this is the Golden Ale. Go in a pub and taste it, especially if you're a lager drinker. Taste something like that, you'll go, that's lovely. But you're not getting smashed off your seat with a, you know, an assault of kind of your senses of kind of fruits and things all jumping on you and mass and kind of gang molesting you and stuff, you know. Yeah, that is glorious. Let's give that another go. Oh, see, there's those fruity hops in there. There are those fruity hops in there, but and on the nose they're big, fairly big anyway. But it's just a beautiful little slight bittery fruity hop finish, almost like a lemon, bit like a you know, lemon face wipe or something like that. There's that little lemony background, lemon pith, lemon zest. A little bit of lemon flesh as well in there, and that's nice. It's just lovely and beautifully bitter at the back, but it's still sweet enough to be nice, and it's that's lovely. That really is lovely. It's got all sorts of relaxed, gentle notes to it. It's, how can I explain this? You know, like you get a lot of beers, they seem to be lemon curd and all that, you know. This is just a little drizzled little lemon cake. It's just a little bit of sponge with nice flavours in it. This is so well done. It's a nice shortbread biscuit is what it is. It's a nice, pardon me. It's not a big chocolate bar or something, or it's not, you know, not one of these sherbet sweets that make your mouth go jump up in the air. This is one of those nice little relaxed things you dip in your tea. Nom nom nom. Nice relaxed beer. This is beautiful. These guys have really got that off to a fine art. Buy it and try it. The label, that should be yellow. The label's a little bit, you know, don't get me wet sort of thing. The label's a little bit gremlin. But the beer inside, he's bloody handsome. Guys are nice as well. Buy it, try it, bloody like it. Oh, wait, hold on. One more thing. What does it look like? With a bit of white behind it, let's have a look. That's what it looks like. Glorious! Buy it, try it, like it, it's lovely. Get it, Daniel. Cheers.